Bada boom, real sky in a room, and you are listening to Yep Wrestling Podcast, the realest podcast in the room.
Greetings, reports unknown. My name is Sunny Sofrito, and today I am joined by
the sensational Miss Chrissy Love.
And I'm also joined by
the greatest general manager in Yep, I Like Wrestling history.
Was that Enzo I just heard, guys?
Oh, yeah, man. Yeah, man.
That's pretty big, guys.
Yeah, so shout out to David Bell, who was at a recent convention that Enzo was hanging out at.
And shout out.
Enzo remembered also hanging out. He wanted to show some love, and there you go. Realest podcast in the room.
That's really dope, guys.
Yeah, man. It was pretty cool. It was pretty cool when, you know.
Pretty
was,
big when he can shout you guys out.
Yeah, yeah. That was pretty dope.
And remember you guys, actually.
Exactly,
A lot of people don't remember when they meet you like a year ago or whatever. So that's pretty cool.
And it was at a club and we were all intoxicated. So that's a whole different story.
Dear.
Welcome to Newark, right?
Shout out to Newark.
Actually, in that case, it was actually the Greenwich Village.
The village brings back memories, Sonny. Brings back memories.
Yeah, we're not talking about your side of the village.
I know, right? So thank you again to Enzo. And don't worry, Sonny, I'm working on Roman Reigns next.
I'm still wondering who you've been catfishing all these guys
with. Don't worry. See what happens when I catfish? You get shout-outs from WWE wrestlers. So there you go.
Oh, so that's what we're going to say.
Up next, yep. Roman Reigns and the Authors of Pain. I'm working on it, Sonny. I'm working on it.
I'm there with you.
Oh, my God.
So, Sonny, we've got some news to cover.
Exactly.
A lot of happenings have been going on in the WWE, starting with another general manager, not a general manager as good as me, but someone on our SmackDown.
So Paige, when she was leaving Money in the Bank, was approached by a fan who happened to put his hands on her face and basically fat shamed her, saying, hey, you need to lose some weight. You know, we joke around a lot on this podcast, but we really want to just make it totally clear. If you're a wrestling fan, that does not give you the right to put your hands on anybody. Anybody whatsoever.
Hashtag not cool at all.
We have to remember wrestlers or superstars, as Vince McMahon would say, we're all playing characters. Much like the character I'm playing right now as a general manager, we have to remember that. Paige is playing a character in the ring. When she's outside that ring, that's a real life person. Like, we need to be careful about how we treat each other. And I know, all joking aside, I've made a lot of, you know, comments towards people, but putting your hands on someone else, I don't know where the rest of you come from, but that's easily a beatdown in the Bronx. Shout out to the Bronx.
Hello.
So, yeah.
Bronx, and Harlem,
I want to say Brooklyn.
Thank you.
Queens.
The mean streets of England as well.
BK.
But, and I'm sorry, fat shaming? Paige?
Nah.
Of all people, right?
I'm sorry, did I miss something?
Exactly.
Exactly. Also, for real, Paige is a gorgeous woman.
Yeah.
You know, we make jokes about everybody.
We do.
And it doesn't matter. Like, everybody that's in WWE does their thing, and they're talented and everything.
Yes.
And, you know, we give them props. We just like to bust their balls and just crack jokes. But at the end of the day, don't disrespect them.
At all.
Speaking of disrespectful acts.
Oh, yeah.
Well.
Big Cass can now teach the unemployment line. See what I did there? Because you can teach unemployment, Sonny. You can teach it. For those of you who don't know, Big Cass was Future Endeavored.
Yeah, I guess you can't teach that, you know. I mean it's crazy. There's rumors coming out that he had like a drinking problem, and
I heard it was mutual through both sides too as well. It's a whole bunch of
There's no such thing as a mutual firing. That's ridiculous. That's why they call it a firing.
I mean, he said he wanted to go, so they was like, all right, you could go. I mean, I don't know. I just read it on Instagram.
The most reliable source of news.
It's like when you're getting broken up with, and then you go, well, I don't like you either. No. You're getting broken up with. Take it like a man, Big Cass.
You're fired. I quit.
Yeah, like that situation. Yeah.
Oh, you can't fire me.
You know, because I quit. I don't need this job. I'll go to TNA and suck there. See how that works?
No. In 3 months after my non-compete.
You know, shout out to Dixie Carter.
No, but he's gotten a lot of heat. The whole thing with when he went overboard with the little person. And then supposedly he broke a door on a bus because he thought they were trying to play a rib on him. And then it just messed it up for everybody else. And then everybody else had to be like, it just a real uncomfortable situation.
It is.
Unfortunately, he hasn't been hot since last year, so.
Well, without Enzo.
That
now
too.
You see, you know.
They shouldn't have broke them up in the first place.
They should not have.
When you got something that's golden, you keep them together. But who
Enzo
knows?
Was the personality, Cass was the muscle, and together they made a dynamic tag team.
Hello.
You take one of those away, and what do you have?
Spoiled milk.
You have Carmella. That's what the fuck we have now.
Listen. Mella is money, bro.
Well, I'm not doing this with you, Sonny. Don't do it, please. Mella is the furthest thing from
you know me. What? Today's your birthday, so we're not even
happy
gonna...
Happy birthday to the general manager!
Shall we go black on you and say, happy birthday
Oh, shout
to...
out to Martin Luther King.
That's Stevie Wonder.
You know
it was
black
for Martin Luther
like
King's
me,
birthday that he made
Thank you.
It.
All black people look
I thought you were talking about who sang it.
Oh, well, no. See, okay.
So now what do you guys think? Do you think Enzo and Cass will reunite on the indies?
Most
or
likely.
Or do you think Enzo may come back to the WWE?
Unless they absolutely fucking hate each other, they coming together to make that money.
Of course.
Money
well,
rules everything.
I think so.
I say you put your feelings aside and just do the money. Much like me hosting this podcast. You put your feelings aside just to make money. So Enzo, if you're listening, Cass, if you're listening, be big boys.
And get those dollars.
Hug it out, kiss it out, roll around, and then go make some money in DNA. See what I did there, Sonny?
Yeah.
See how I added that?
Yeah, I see that. Real quick, for those of you who have never watched the Simon Gotch interview that Kervin did, you got to check it out. He had a really good interview with him where Simon Gotch basically breaks it down and says, yo, a lot of tag teams don't like each other. Even tag teams have been together for a long time because it's like an unhappy marriage. You know, but go back and check it out. He dropped a lot of gems in that. It's in our archives on our YouTube channel as well as in our SoundCloud or iTunes. So moving on, unfortunate news came out right before we started recording,
yeah,
that Big Van Vader passed away, a.k.a. Leon White, at the age of 63 due to a pneumonia.
R.I.P., man.
Yeah, I wasn't aware that he was ill. Right. But, you know, the guy provided a lot of memories in the ring and then also some real happy memories out of the ring with his appearance on Boy Meets World.
Man, that's one of my fave episodes. It reminds me of my childhood, guys.
Oh, yeah.
On Channel 7.
On ABC.
On ABC. Yes. TGIF. You had, remember, he was the mean dad, but he was a wrestler, and Corey and him had to go fight in the wrestling, in the ring with him. It was great, man.
Shout out to Topanga. I had a crush on Topanga back when I thought women weren't icky. I do think that now.
Who
but
wasn't icky?
I loved Topanga.
Topanga was the shit back
I also
then.
Loved Corey, which was a little confusing for me on TGIF. But in any event, my favorite Vader moment is actually a real moment. His mother was so small... The doctor told her, your baby is growing at an alarming rate and we have to do a cesarean now at like 7 months. Because literally she was like 4 feet tall and Vader was growing at such a vast speed. They said, if you carry this baby to term, you will die. Because there was no way. Vader was born at like 12 pounds. So yeah.
Wow.
So yeah, that's my favorite Vader story.
I don't know why, but I just pictured a baby dressed as Vader just kicking out through the belly button and just like... Wow, I'm here.
Yep.
So you see how big of a man he was, and it turns out his mother was a very, very tiny woman, but she ruled the family with an iron fist. She was one of those moms, tiny in stature, but very scary and
stern.
Wait, so his mom was Puerto Rican?
Because oh, like wow. Yeah. Shout out to Puerto Ricans everywhere.
So, you know, rest in peace to Big Van Vader and... you know, our condolences to his family and, you know, hope he's going to live on in all our memories as wrestling fans.
Yep.
So, that said, let's move on to some WWE TV. And before we continue, let me just acknowledge everybody else that's in the room because we basically all snuck in to basically surprise Teddy. So, we got Ruby in the house.
Woo! How you doing? Talk to me, but only for talking dirty.
We also got Lucy in the house.
Hey, guys.
And we also got Mr. Roger Adams in the house.
Name dropper.
Hello, people. I actually had to sell a share to even make it out here, but you know.
Oh, God.
What? Jesus
for
Christ.
Teddy? I'm absolutely coming out for his birthday.
Oh, it's the general manager's birthday.
Wait, hold on.
Happy birthday, Teddy. Sorry, I've had a lot of wine.
So Roger. Wait. We're not going to just... We're not going to breeze over the fact that Roger just said, I have to come out for his birthday.
Ooh,
so, dude.
Wow.
No.
See how he did that?
I was like, I mean, I can't be a friend to a gay man without like you making references like that. I mean, come on, come on, come on.
I literally like being the only queer at a table, Sonny. Don't ever cast another queer on this podcast because I quit.
But, Roger, you're holding the microphone so gingerly.
Because I can't, you know, go against the microphone because it'll cause static. You understand the basic tenets of broadcast, right?
I can always educate.
All right, so...
Which one of you guys actually watched NXT? Because I took Roger's advice and I watched NXT for the first time this weekend, and guess what? There was some sliding going on, Sonny. There was sliding in Newark.
Teddy, I'm telling you, man, it's like they don't have a bad show on the roster when
Roger,
it comes to takeovers.
I will believe everything you say from now on. I took your advice and I was pleasantly surprised.
Same here. I was sliding with you, Teddy. Mm. I took the advice of you guys and my brother. Shout out to them. And I watched it for the first time. And I can say they won for the weekend. Just want to say that. And I was pleasantly surprised and enjoyed the whole show.
They always win for the weekend.
That's what everyone's been saying to me.
I just love how tight it was. It was like...
From beginning to end.
2.5 hours, not a bad match on the card. That never is a bad match on the card.
It was tight. They were in and out. It didn't drag.
I don't understand why it only took you guys so long to watch until now.
I apologize.
And then I understood the stories. Like, you showed the little behind-the-scenes stuff. I understood what was happening.
I mean, as someone that was there at the first Brooklyn takeover that changed everything.
Jesus.
I feel
Christ.
Like you guys just haven't like really given them like the chance they deserve.
I'm not even
going
to lie to you. I was actually looking at takeover for Brooklyn tickets.
Yep.
I was looking at it. I was like, should I?
I will not be at SummerSlam, but I will be at takeover.
Should I?
Well, I decided to take a gander at NXT for one match in particular.
Which match?
Ricochet versus some other black guy. I don't recall his name, but...
Prince.
Prince. I don't know. Hulk Hogan. I don't know who it was, but I know one thing.
The Velveteen.
Is that his name?
Velveteen Dream.
Is that his name? I was thinking Ahmed Johnson, but I knew that wasn't right because I felt... I felt that I was wrong when I was thinking
like
that.
Velveteen Dream actually has kidneys that work.
Ooh.
That was shaved.
I mean,
he was always out for his kidneys. I remember growing up in 1996 with him being gone for months because of his kidneys.
Shout out to Ahmed Johnson. But yes, Ricochet delivered, as I knew he would.
They both delivered, though. And again, for me not knowing anything, but I know that they hated each other. And it was a great damn match.
Let me ask you very quickly.
Yes, go ahead.
Was his attire a swipe at Hulk Hogan, or was it an homage to Hogan?
Oh, my God. This actually works on two levels.
Oh, really?
In the very beginning, it is a homage to Hulk Hogan, but his actual, like, tights is actually Prince Puma's tights, which Ricochet actually gave him.
What?
Well, look at this.
Yeah.
That's very interesting.
If you got to get heat, you got to do it the right way.
Right.
And then he was flexing like Hulk Hogan, too. He was doing everything.
And that was just to throw you off the scent. This is like a personal thing between him and quote-unquote Prince Puma, a.k.a. Ricochet.
Oh, so all Prince Puma is
Hulk Hogan thing was just for us marks, basically.
Okay.
I know the tights you wear. I'm going to mess with you just based on that.
That was one of my favorite matches. And besides the women with the crazy girl...
Nikki Cross.
Oh my God, she's a psychopath.
What? She reminded me of a Luna Vachon. Like, she did this thing where...
That is so...
Crazy, but it wasn't just an outland... Like, Alicia Fox does this outlandish craziness where you're like, girl, have several seats. But Nikki Cross did it how Luna used to do it, where you're like,
yes!
Wow. But you know she can work. It's not just a watch me yell and scream.
Mm-hmm.
She went in there and worked. It was like, wow. It was like watching... Luna Vachon all over again.
Like,
so I
reincarnated. Yes.
You know what though, Teddy? Though I remember the first long conversation I ever had with you was about the women's division.
Oh.
I confess to you my longtime love for Luna Vachon.
See, it's definitely. I like to see up and coming wrestlers
pay homage.
Who remind me of wrestlers of yesteryear. Shout out to Luna Vachon.
Like,
may she
rest
in peace.
There's nobody else like Luna Vachon.
But I definitely see Nikki Cross embodying that. And I know I've taken a few swipes at Shayna Baszler, but she can put on.
A pretty good show.
How would you take a swipe at someone that could choke you out?
Well, oh,
my God. I'd take it softly, and I wouldn't take it in her presence.
I don't think you have the option to take it softly.
But the rest of the card was amazing, seeming as how I didn't know who anyone was.
Me.
But I was still watching. I was like, okay, I want this guy.
I mean, that's what good wrestling does. You don't care about the people, but a good match absorbs you into its storytelling.
Weren't you rather entertained, like you were just from beginning to end? Like, I couldn't. I didn't want to move. I didn't even want to press pause. Like, it was just...
If I'm ever in a dark alley, I want Aleister Black to be at the end of it. Come and get
me. Aleister Black versus Lars Sullivan. I mean, I had a feeling that Lars was not going to win, but like, Aleister Black is the future. Like, if any type of WWE main roster upgrade involves him not winning a championship, I'm going to be highly upset.
Well, you never know. That might be in the near future. Because you know what happens when you go to the next level.
I was like, yeah, Vince doesn't like... He's not like 7 foot tall and 400 pounds. I don't like him.
He likes those big men. Shout out to Vinnie Mac.
Yeah, shout out to the WWE stock for being so high. It's $67.71.
Roger.
The last match took me home. That reminded me of old Attitude back in the day when we saw... color, we didn't give a shit. We were all over the damn arena.
Like, that match would have been a regular episode of Raw.
That would have, and SmackDown all together.
Yep.
Both back-to-back shows.
Absolutely.
So I have a question for you guys. How is it the powers that be, the wizard behind the curtain, can put on a show like NXT?
That is shorter too, by the way.
But then the next day have a pretty sucktacular pay-per-view. 2 days later, have a suckalicious Raw. And then 3 days later, have a sucktacular SmackDown.
I love how you put suck in there all
see what
that
I did
time.
There? See
I love
what I did
that.
There?
I like that. I like how
so
you did
what
that.
What is happening? How can we have one show that's literally amazing and then literally the next day, sucking it?
So on that, I'm going to disagree with you because
and
I didn't think.
You never do that, Sonny.
Yeah. I didn't think Money in the Bank was that bad. I thought it was pretty decent.
I thought Money in the Bank was one of the best pay-per-views this year.
Well, actually, by comparison, that doesn't really say a lot. But I actually thought it was a good. I actually thought Money in the Bank was a really good pay-per-view too. Because I mean, all the ladies came out and did amazing.
They left it all in the ring.
I mean, the ladies definitely outperformed the men. That was definitely this week.
Yes.
You know.
I just thought it was a really engaging pay-per-view.
Since I was outside filming, I didn't see a lot of Money in the Bank, so perhaps...
Wait, what are you trying to say? Trying to say that I had you out working like
I was being worked like a immigrant child. Cut that out, Sonny, because we don't talk like that on this podcast.
I watched it with my comfy pants.
I didn't get a chance to see
glasses,
a lot of it.
I took my contact lenses out.
Oh, you
I
were.
Had
oh, you,
fucking...
you were real comfortable.
Oh,
you,
I had two of my boyfriends, Ben and Jerry. Oh, I was braless all day, baby.
Oh, you were letting it
I had
fry
two
free.
Of my boyfriends, Ben and Jerry.
Oh, my goodness. I was made to perform like a circus monkey.
And I don't mean the mouse and the cat. I mean the ice cream.
Okay. That's Tom and Jerry, but all right.
See, that's the Pinot Grigio, guys. That's what happens on the Yep podcast.
Hashtag drinking and wrestling.
Hashtag just Lucy T, like fucking drunk. But yo, I thought that Money in the Bank was an amazing pay per view, apart from Roman v. Jinder Mahal.
You know what? Actually, I got to stop you there. The match wasn't that bad.
It was awful. Are you joking me? There was a fucking beach ball, and it was not even the Raw after WrestleMania.
I didn't think it was that bad. I think it was just...
Oh, it was terrible. And you know what? And here, Sonny, here is what made it so terrible. A title like the freaking Universal title needs to be defended at a large pay-per-view like Money in the Bank. And because it was not, we were stuck with filling the fucking card with a match of Roman v. Jinder Mahal. And it was bullshit.
You know what? You make a really good point. If they're going to try and treat Money in the Bank now as the top five, as opposed to having the top four pay-per-views.
It was, okay, Teddy, I know it's your birthday, but.
Didn't you break up with him for Ricochet?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Fuck. Carry
on. Thank you. I thought you liked his tights.
Wow.
But I just have to say, like, the women stole the show. I mean, the women's Money in the Bank ladder match, in my opinion, was much more entertaining than the men's. I really liked, which was not a thing last year, they each individually had a moment at the top of the ladder.
They showed that they belonged there. That's the most important thing.
I was like, yeah, that match was a very, very impressive match. I definitely agree with Lucy.
Yeah.
Thank you, Roger. Lucy.
So let's break down some of the matches real quick. Ronda Rousey.
Amazing.
What did you think, Ruby?
So, as my good friend Teddy loves to say, I was sliding, Sonny.
Is sliding a good thing?
Sliding is an amazing thing. Okay. I was sliding all over the place. Uncontrollable sliding. It was summertime, and I was a little kid again, and I couldn't control the sliding. all over the place.
You do realize that when Teddy talks about it, it means it's because he's wet from his panties.
Yes, right? And I was entirely moist.
Same.
The whole match, constantly.
My brain was moist.
As I said last week, Rhonda is the only person that I would let snap my arm. And she can snap my arm, my legs, my ankles. She do whatever she wants to me.
Okay, Jerry Ferrara.
Okay, but Ruby, don't you think, like, that Rhonda, like, okay, we were just talking, okay, fine, she made you want to slip and slide. I think she makes everyone want to slip and slide.
No, not me. Veto, I say. I was actually quite dry during that entire match.
Okay, well, you're English, so it's a little different. But I have to say, like, don't you agree that she is developing her in-ring skills? She's getting that attitude that needs to be established, needs to be cultivated, that really differentiates the Brock Lesnars from, say, the Seth Rollins.
Even with all of the cons that supposedly everyone brings up about her, she's settling in. She's becoming more comfortable, and you can see it. Even there was a point in the match where she was being bear hugged, and she was selling it. And she looked into it. She looked like she was in pain, but, you know.
I want to be bear hugged by Nia Jax.
Yeah. Nia, if you're out there, girl, talk to me, but only if you're talking dirty.
So here's the funny thing about that. That entire match, I'm watching it. I'm already not looking forward to it because I already know I'm beating Sea Urchin next year, which, you know, because it's looking like she's going to become amazing in the ring.
I think she's going to,
And she's just getting better and better. I'm so, like,
she really is. She's proving and she's improving.
I have one question though. Do you think she'll ever separate herself from the Rowdy gimmick?
The only way that it will happen will be if it's to change her character dramatically.
But for everyone who's everyone who like is listening right now, I just want to let you know it's really funny right now because Ruby and I are giving each other the same frog faced look. Where you're like, you got this, you got this, you got this, you got this. Okay, I got it.
I feel like I'm about to be tag team and not in the way that Teddy likes.
No, it's cool. I'm going to tag Ruby in.
Besides all that, which is amazing because we are giving each other visual cues. Can you classify her right now? Because I just see her as someone that wants a title. You know what I'm saying?
Shoot, Ruby. Maybe we're not on the same team right now.
No, but I'm saying no.
But yeah, you know what? It she is kind of a tweener.
Well, In Between Her, by the way, is a very good British show on Netflix and Hulu. It's very funny, so that's what I'm thinking of right now. I was also very upset that Alexa Bliss won the Money in the Bank contract. That being said, I am glad that she, at the same time, ended up cashing it in because I was not looking forward to months and months of Alexa Bliss promos that she was Miss Money in the Bank.
All right, so Lucy, I'm going to have to steal the mic from someone to just disagree. Because I firmly believe Alexa Bliss is the future. And I've been throwing up the hashtag, a decade of bliss.
Right, but don't you think that Money in the Bank is a pay-per-view and an opportunity for somebody who might not otherwise have had a certain opportunity at a title shot and just in general in the WWE?
I definitely do.
Listen, my good people. You know, I was sliding. And I was trying to get up, and I was full-blown life alert on the floor. I've fallen, and I can't get up. And then Alexa Bliss won the Money in the Bank match, and all the caution, floors, wet signs were falling, and my feet were slippery, and I couldn't gain balance.
Okay,
and
I literally want to retire sliding. It was funny when I used to do it. Now it's not good when straight boys slide. Like,
that term. I mean,
it was not meant for straight men to slide. It was not good. I was literally feeling sandpaper when Alexa Bliss cashed in, like the opposite of sliding. It was like,
I was like, you guys don't understand. There's a full decade of bliss on the horizon. Like, she's the future. I don't know. Who's more entertaining than Alexa Bliss? Not.
How much time you got?
Not Becky Lynch.
Becky Lynch, Charlotte Flair, Ember Moon.
Give Alexa Bliss.
You used the word entertaining.
Were you equally as disappointed with the winner of the women's ladder match as you were with the men's? Because Braun went ahead.
Wasn't.
So you were happy that Braun won.
It's like Braun is like it's
Chrissy.
The future.
Were you happy that Braun won?
Vince has a hard on for big people and blondes.
The grapefruits.
Can you please just say Do your Vince impersonation, Roger.
Oh, this Braun Strowman, he's a big, tall fellow. He's all the champions.
I'm literally vomiting in my mouth, people.
So but you loved Teddy, Alexa, and you hated Braun.
I hated that Alexa Bliss won. I am equally as upset that Braun won for the exact same reason.
I feel you. Ruby, what do you think?
Teddy, we spoke about Braun last week. You said he was terrible, and not like him.
No.
But are you going to sit there and tell me that he wasn't amazing in that match? Teddy.
Yes, I'll say it. I'll say it loudly.
Awesome. Yes. He ran through a ladder, Teddy.
So what? I once fell off a ladder. It doesn't matter.
He was being elevator jumped with every single turn of the match.
I get jumped every time I go to Washington Heights. What's your point?
Go ahead, Sonny.
It was 9:05 live in that bitch.
Oh, no. So, okay, well, let's just do a quick rack up. Give it a grade. Give Money in the Bank a grade.
I would give it a C-.
C-. Ruby, give it a grade.
I'll give it a B-.
B-.
And the only reason is because Roman and more Roman.
Chrissy, give me a grade.
C.
Lucy, give me a grade, quick.
I'm giving this shit a B+.
I will give it a D because D has always been my favorite. Always been my favorite. Sonny, wrap us up.
My grade was a solid B.
Oh, crap. All right, so let's move on to Raw, shall we?
I like it Raw.
Hey.
Oh, Chrissy.
As we start talking about the Monday Night Wrestling program.
Say Raw.
Yo, actually, you know what? Fuck it. I'm going to say that it got Raw because...
Oh, don't you love it?
Rondo got Raw in the beginning.
And here I am dry again. I will let Ruby talk about Rhonda because he does it much better than I do.
She is living up to her name as the baddest woman on the planet.
This goes back to my point of being a tweener.
Well, here's the thing.
Rhonda came in, and I'm going to tell you right now, remember that match when it was the three-way dance between Kane, Brock Lesnar, and Braun Strowman? And Braun Strowman basically got a little too extra, and Brock gave that...
Brock tightened it up, yeah.
Yeah, and he gave him that quick punch to the head and to the gut.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I saw coming out of Rhonda. Rhonda took... I mean, it looked like it was... I mean, yeah, it may have been a work, but it was a work that hurt.
Refresh my memory, because I was having dinner made for me by a very lovely person in Newark, so I miss Rhonda losing her shit. Who she tightened someone else up or someone tightened her up?
She tightened up.
Who she tightened up?
Alexa Bliss. Alexa Bliss, Kurt Angle, 5 refs.
I immediately want to stop this because you don't have the background to go tighten up a veteran wrestler. Like, if a veteran makes a mistake, guess what? That just happened. It may remind me of something. One time Tina Turner did a dance on stage and she did the wrong dance and everyone said, no, no. Whatever Tina does is right. The backup dancer's fucked up. So if Kurt Angle or Alexa Bliss do something, Rhonda is new to the game. But follow...
I don't remember when Roman did that.
See, we don't do this. See, I said Tina Turner, now he's making Roman Reigns jokes. Anyway...
It's in here, Tina. It's in here.
Ronda Rousey she's too new in the game to be going off script, you know.
I don't think it was off script.
I think it was a part of the whole
script. It was
a
work. Yeah. It was just that it looked like it was off script.
She can't be giving stiff shots either. She can't be giving stiff shots.
No, but
like,
I mean, if she,
yeah,
I don't like it.
You just hating.
I do.
If I can just
with her one stupid braid, I hate it.
Disgusting.
And her ballerina shit makeup, I don't like it. I'm over it. And I'm beginning to hate Rowdy Piper now because of her sucking off his poor memory.
She's ruining it.
Those are the words and opinions.
What?
Teddy, and they do not necessarily represent...
That's not fair. I'm sorry.
You know what? Fuck it. It's your birthday.
Give me a pass. Come on,
was honestly here for the disclaimer, and I was very excited. I grabbed the mic with all kinds
That's
of
attention. That's why you're here.
He's back. No.
That's why you're here.
You know what? Because it's his birthday, I'll allow
you
it.
Let him slide?
See, we're not doing this.
I let him slide.
Well, I'm going to tell you. Okay, I did have a slide moment during Raw. Here was my slide moment. When Bayley snatched Sasha by the back of her weave. I love a good weave snatching. I've always loved a good weave snatching. For those of you who's grown up in New York City, when one hoe grabs another hoe's weave, I've lived for that moment. So when Bayley finally reached out and snatched the purple weave, I did a little sliding.
Too Luke fucking warm. Sasha needed to take a fucking chair to Bayley's back.
It was just
because
enough.
Because I feel like, no, I'm sorry. They have been trying to reset this feud 4 months.
Don't get me wrong. I hate the feud, but you know what I missed?
There is no feud because it's literally like we are all, as the WWE Universe, we are all sitting in some fucking lukewarm bath water with pubes floating in it because they keep trying to run a hot bath. Yeah. Well, yeah, they keep trying to run a hot bath as a feud between Sasha and Bayley. But all that ends up happening is that Sasha and Bayley forget, oh, sorry, we actually forgot that we
I liked it.
So wait. Yeah, honestly, I felt like all we needed was some Vaseline because they looked like they were two girls on the Bronx on the Fordham Road.
Now tell me you don't love a good chick fight. Come on, Sonny. Come on.
Hey, man, Grand Concourse.
Thank you.
In the Bronx panties?
There's a 2% straight boy who lives inside of me who loves a good chick fight. So I love a good weave snatching. I always have. But here's what I miss. Ever since the Divas Revolution, now they're female competitors, which you know I hate. I miss the Divas. You know what I also miss? Backstage catfights. Because think about it, we haven't had a backstage catfight since the Divas Revolution. So welcome back, backstage catfights. There they were. They were rolling around. There was hair pulling. All I needed was an evening gown match, and I would have been equally as happy.
Evening gown or brown panties? Which one?
Well, it's Bayley, so I don't need to see her, like, you know, unclothed. But...
Those are the thoughts and opinions.
Oh, my God.
No,
okay.
All right.
Give me a show of hands. Who really wants to see Bayley undressed? There is one person with his hand up.
I wouldn't mind out of curiosity's sake.
Ew.
I mean, I'll allow it for one day, maybe.
You're,
for the record, can you make it a no?
Excuse me, waitress. Bring me a broomstick, and then I'll show her what Bayley looks like naked. Thank you.
Oh.
That's terrible.
Those are the opinions and thoughts.
Oh, goodness. Are your hands still up, Ruby?
Yes, they are.
You like my nephew wanting me to carry him around. Put your arms down. Goodness. Oh, shout out to my nephew.
Those are the thoughts and opinions of...
So that was my only sliding moment during Raw. To be honest, the rest of the show, not as good. I am slowly losing my love for Roman. I never had any love for Bobby Lashley.
That was the only bad spot of that episode. That was the only bad spot of the episode.
I was like, I don't understand the people that say, oh, Roman Reigns is a great wrestler. I was like, he's barely passable. Like, what am I watching?
I'm losing it.
You guys are.
I'm losing it. Ever since I met Ricochet, it's like, Roman who? Finn Balor.
Exactly.
Finn Balor what?
The way it should be.
The authors of where? No, I don't know anyone's name. You can have Finn. He's all yours now.
Okay, thank you.
Oh, he's all yours.
No problem.
And what's the deal with Finn, actually? It's like, I don't understand why he's so popular besides the paint.
Sexy.
Yeah, all right, so let me run down this card right now and just give you my quick thoughts. The opening segment was dope. Dolph Ziggler beating Seth Rollins was dope.
Garbage.
Yep, garbage.
Bobby Roode and Kurt Hawkins, that was trash.
Yeah, I agree.
The leader of Worlds and the B team.
Greatest segment ever.
How many of you marked out when you saw Bo Dallas do Bray Wyatt?
Just about to mention that. That was awesome, hilarious.
Awesome.
And he looked so much like him that it was just perfect.
And he talked just like him too. Great.
This is about
spot
the time
on.
I got home.
Brotherly love.
I turned on my television, and for a split second, I did think it was the Fashion Police doing it. It wasn't until Curtis Axel started speaking that I was like, oh, wait, that's the B team doing it. But you know what? Do we really need another funny tag team?
But they do it so much better. Like,
but how many do we need?
But they're actually really funny. Like, Fashion Police isn't funny anymore.
I would say they were never funny.
We need as many that can have me tune in to actually watch the tripe that they are presenting.
Same.
Okay, then we need to get rid of another funny tag team then.
Get rid of that fashion crap. Garbage.
But you got to understand that it's for parody. On SmackDown, which, you know, a lot of us were not paying attention to, that's where you had all the comedy tag teams on. Now they switch them all over to Raw. So let's also always remember something. It's a show at the end of the day. So the thing is that, you know, they're booking it as a show. So you have to have your comic relief. And the comic relief now is within the tag team division. Whereas, you know, all the other is the serious or what have you. Now on SmackDown, all the tag teams are serious.
Except the New Day.
Yeah, but they're serious, but with almost like a silliness to them. But
so
they're not really
shout out to
comedy.
Pancakes
in the house.
Shall we move on to SmackDown then? Since you've said the magic words, might as well. Since you opened Pandora's box, let's move on to SmackDown.
I mean, there no thoughts on the fact that Jinder Mahal took on Chad Gable, and there was somebody in the crowd with a sign saying, "Sunil Singh is not a weapon."
Shout out to Sunil Singh. So cute.
That
so
was
cute.
A great sign, though, by the way.
That sign, yeah, honestly, that sign was the best, one of the best things. And also...
shout out to signs. Not a lot of people bring signs anymore.
Yeah. But I also want to make mention to the fact that No Way Jose lost. And it serves him right because he brought out a really subpar entourage.
Not Sonny not liking someone in the No Way Jose conga line. Well, look at this.
Mm-hmm.
Look who's raised the standards of
I did see
week.
That when they came out. I was like, well, who's on the line today? And yeah, there was nobody really decent to look at. I can agree with you.
No chicken heads for you, Sonny? None? Nothing.
None whatsoever.
Really?
I was looking.
That's probably why he lost, because there was no one on his line that was good.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, and note that when the line leaves.
And he lost to Mojo Rawley.
Of all people. Look at that. Mojo. I forgot he was even on Raw.
Yeah, I thought he was still on SmackDown.
Me too.
Shout out to Mojo Rawley. He works at Dairy Queen now. So speaking of chicken heads, James Ellsworth is back on my TV screen, and I have never wanted to kill myself more. Oh my Lanta. James Ellsworth.
Listen, I felt bad for him when he was let go, and I saw his Instagram post, and he was with his child, and it was
rough. No, wait, stop.
Wait,
with his what?
His child?
He has reproduced.
He has.
Some woman that's shocking. Down
that's
him.
Shocking.
Yuck.
What?
Barf in my... Ugh.
I guess there's a pot for every lid.
And I felt... but,
oh. I'm here all week.
All Tip week, baby. How you doing? Talk to me.
I thought James Ellsworth was defending the Intergender Championship across the Indies.
Yuck.
And as soon as he came back, I hated him again. I hate him even more now because he came out as
Asuka.
Definitely
that Asuka mask, I was deeply offended.
Ruined my whole hentai vibe.
So shout out to hentai. Getting teenage boys through the night for years to come. No pun intended.
Animated orgasms, let's go on.
So shout out to Pornhub. So here's the thing. Asuka is being mocked by not only losing to Carmella, now she is losing to James Ellsworth as well, and we have just ruined something that was great.
I mean, how many chromosomes does he have? I don't think it's either more or less than what you're supposed to have, James Ellsworth.
It's to the point where it's like, it's just, again, something shoved down our faces and our throats is like, okay, here, we're going to give this back to you again. Yeah.
You loved him against Braun Strowman, though.
But do you understand?
That's different,
that
though.
Carmella was the first woman to pin Asuka 1, 2, bloody 3. Because remember, Charlotte tapped her out.
Yes,
Carmella
that's true.
Carmella is the first woman, I literally want to throw up as I'm saying this, to pin Asuka.
She did beat Charlotte for it twice, which she likes to often say
that's
in the promos.
Fucking problem,
it just has a oh my god, like you've ruined something that was so good.
I don't know why she was staring at along with doing the mask, but
yeah, that was the.
That's Asuka. I'm sorry, but that is Asuka's fucking problem. If she cannot handle a distraction like a lookalike coming to the ring,
well, if I was
that's
doing this
her
podcast
problem.
Right now, and another Teddy walked in, I'd be like, "What the fuck is
but
this?"
But that would be, but that would be Teddy's problem.
Is that right, Fago?
Oh, which,
but
by
that
the way,
would be
we should actually
problem.
Tell you that we're replacing you after the end of this podcast.
No.
But we couldn't replace you.
I just mean like...
What?
Teddy's ears perked up.
You've already replaced me in one episode of this.
What was that? That I can't replace who? What? I'm sorry, what?
For all of you listening before, two podcasts ago, I was fired and rehired. And, you know,
in the same
replaced
show.
By Roger as he sits in front of me.
Yeah, but I was also fired and rehired twice.
Hashtag real loyalty.
I'm just saying, this Carmella beating Asuka was just... I have not... This was a huge, huge
upset.
Wrestling... I can't even remember one of recent years that was so remarkably bad.
Yes.
I
mean, Carmella is just boring to me. Like, she's just a plain piece of Staten Island toast that belongs in the landfill along with the rest of that borough.
I disagree. I do not think that Carmella is boring. I think that she is SmackDown Live Women's Champion for a reason. I think that her skills, just like Ronda Rousey's skills, have equally been improving over the past couple of months. And the fact that Asuka got distracted by Asuka is Asuka's fucking problem. Like, Asuka, get a grip.
I mean, I think she's still trash, no matter how well your words are placed, Lucy. We do appreciate you here, but I don't see how Carmel is in any way valuable to the women's division besides her moonwalking
why?
Being a cheerleader.
Really, why?
Only because, like, she's really not that great. She annoys me more. Not even as, like, a heel character, but, like, she's just not there. She's not present in terms of actual ability.
So wait, doesn't that make sense that she's valuable because of the fact that, remember, and as I continue to say over and over again, you have to antagonize your audience as much as entertain your audience in wrestling.
That's why Alexa Bliss is more powerful in her role than Carmella will ever be.
No, but let's be real about something. Some of the best heels are shitty in the ring. It's just that they have the right character that antagonizes the audience. And a perfect person to bring up for that, JBL. JBL was fucking horrible in the ring.
I don't actually consider horrible in the ring. I think that's an absurd notion.
I thought JBL was horrible in the ring.
That's an absurd notion, actually. It's like, I mean, I'm not the greatest defender of JBL, although he has been defending liberals everywhere.
Okay, so you know what? Let me take that back.
Please do.
I mean, that clothesline.
No. Let me elaborate a little bit more.
Damn.
The skill set he put on display when he was John Bradshaw Layfield, you know, the money-making Texan and all that shit. Yo, his in-ring sucked. When he was in the APA, I loved his stuff. And before that, his stuff was good. But when he was JBL, he was horrible in the ring. But his character got him over. A lot of good heels tend to not be that great in the ring, but their character gets them over because you want your hero to finally vanquish them. And if they're really whack in the ring, it's even more of a reason that you want to see them finally lose. So it's almost like it's the chase.
But what you're saying is basically a wrestler at the end of his career got worse. That was JBL was the end of his career.
No, I know so, that, but like, it's not. But we're not putting it in terms of him being at the end of his career. We're talking about that incarnation of that character. We never really thought about it in terms of timing, age, or anything like that. We're just looking at it as, all right, he's a champ. He sucks in the ring. I want John Cena to beat him.
So
for it to take so long for John Cena to finally beat him at that time, you know, a lot of people hated JBL in the ring too.
So Sonny, I'm curious.
Everything's relative. Yeah, go ahead.
I'm curious. Given your analysis of JBL and his purpose of being a heel in and out of the ring, what are your feelings about Carmella? And I wonder if they're different given the time and the gender.
No, actually, I like what Carmella's doing for her character.
Yuck. Said no one ever.
So the thing is that you got to remember, she is the chase. Everybody's got to chase her.
Yuck.
If anything, the worst that she is in the ring, the more is going to antagonize people that want to see her lose. Because then all of a sudden it's like, damn, man, when is she going to lose? And then she keeps on winning by the skin of her teeth. Now she's winning because Ellsworth is back. She's winning because she's narrowly escaping. I would not be surprised if at some point she turns face, she starts showing that she can actually work in the ring.
With that face, I doubt it. Here's what could have happened, right?
Okay.
Ruby had a good point with Asuka. Let him do it.
Okay, so Asuka's reaction to Ellsworth, which she didn't know who it was behind the mask, could that be a possible way to usher in the other Japanese talent that is in NXT, like Kairi Sane, because of her reaction to that?
Had we had a woman come in and do that Ellsworth spot, and we have that woman in NXT, that could have easily set something up for Asuka, like, wait, who's this woman?
I disagree.
Dot, dot, dot. But instead, we've let James Ellsworth do it, and now we are mocking Asuka, a champion of, what, 300-some-odd days? So now she gets to job to Ellsworth and Carmella.
But the thing is that didn't the in-ring segment that they had this past week show how badass Asuka is with the turnaround kick and just knocking him down to the ground?
But then we let Carmella kick her in the face.
Yeah, she's that heel that takes advantage of any situation.
I find it gross. I Roger, what do you think?
So, you know what, Sonny? You know, I like you as a person. You've been very kind to me over the years, but I'm going to highly disagree with you with all that Carmella shit that you just spouted. It's like the whole idea of wrestling is a heel to be a heel. A heel has to do heel things to generate hatred from the audience. Wrestling bad is the exact opposite of that. You're talking about X-Pac heat.
Yeah. Oh, like, shout out to drugs everywhere.
Because that whole thing is ridiculous. I want everybody to be good so I can watch good matches. Not watch a heel with a belt that wrestles poorly and it's like, why is she in this position? Why is she not in NXT?
My feelings for Carmella, I am not really a fan of hers. Never really was. But she's entertaining, yes.
Yeah.
Comparing, but again, I still don't like her. I think she's annoying. I hate that she's champion. I don't like Carmella. I don't like anything she does. She's actually annoying. And I don't want to watch her sometimes. But for the fact that they had the whole Elmsworth thing, I didn't like none of that too. I think the whole match, it made the whole match that they were having, I think it brought it down.
Thank you.
I think it brought, I think him coming to the ring brought the match down because they were having a great match.
And again,
I don't like Carmella, but that match between her and Asuka, I think was very good until he came and a guy came and ruined it. Yeah. Yet again, him coming to ruin things like he did last year's Money in the Bank, he came and ruined it.
If we're going to make her a heel, let her be a heel by herself. We don't need her.
To I need her to stand
valet,
on top
of
that. Exactly.
A valet
I need this
who
woman
looks
to
like
stand
Sunny.
On top.
But let me ask you something. Do you don't think the fact that she has Ellsworth with her adds to her heat, or is it taking away from her heat?
Definitely taking away from it.
Because doesn't it make you hate it a little bit more because
he's
involved?
Yes, it makes me hate her more because now, again, they're pushing this gimmick with them together. I thought they were gone. I thought she was mad at him and he left and all other crap like that. But they put them back together because even when she was when she ran out the ring and she seen him, she kind of like looked at him like kind of like sideways a little bit. But that's just me observing everybody that's in the ring. That's just me doing that. Mm. But again, I don't know, like, it makes you hate the gimmick even more. I just hate the whole thing in general. I think it's like, if she's going to be good, let her be good by herself.
Yeah.
We don't need a man to help her be pushed over.
There are other female heels who could do this better than Carmella's doing. Like, for instance, Becky Lynch took on half of Sanity.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, Billie Kay. I get Sanity and the Iconics confused. I always confuse those two tag teams. I'm sorry. But yeah.
Those are the thoughts and opinions.
Oh, come on.
Of Teddy, and they do not reflect
the thoughts. Are you trying to tell me you all can tell the difference between the Iconics and Sanity? Really?
Yeah.
I thought it was the
Ascension. I certainly can.
Really?
They don't look as pretty.
It doesn't look like Victor from the Ascension. Are you telling me that?
Yes.
Oh. Can we get to
again, those are the thoughts and opinions of Teddy.
Double disclaimer. Fine. Keep it moving.
I mean, but going back to the whole Carmella thing, I mean, Carmella's heat is kind of dwindled ever since Ellsworth has left. I mean, I think we can agree on that a little bit. Yeah. I mean, so adding him back to the proceedings as like another like touch point, another heat point, basically, because she definitely wasn't responding to her all that much without Ellsworth.
The only reason why I like Carmella now is because she didn't have Ellsworth. I'm just going to throw that in there.
Although that is funny, though, at least two people at this table have mentioned that, you know, she was better by herself.
Yeah. So let's keep it moving. There was a happy note. Happy Rusev Day, everyone.
Happy Rusev Day!
Am I the only one who's getting just a little bit happy that maybe Rusev is finally going to get his day in the sun?
Because he's not.
Oh.
I'm going to tell you that straight up.
You've ruined a wet dream, Roger.
What WWE's doing is sprinkling a little seasoning on your hopes and dreams, and it's going to snatch that away as soon as they find it convenient for them.
Now, come on now. AJ has had that belt since I don't know when. Isn't it time to maybe give it to someone else? And
no.
Isn't Rusev?
Absolutely not.
Really?
Who is better than AJ on SmackDown?
Rusev?
No.
Shinsuke?
No.
Wow. I'll
be straight up with you. Shinsuke coming to WWE has probably damaged his career more than any of us want to let on. It's making him tons of money. But, like, he's had 6 title matches with 0 types of wins.
But
that's
he's entertaining
bad.
The hell out of everyone. And he finally knows English now. That was amazing.
I mean,
he
knew English.
I mean,
they took that mouth guard out of his mouth, and now he's able to speak properly.
And poor Renee with her coat looking like Bobby Heenan with that coat on.
Renee will be fine. She goes back up the canon of Dean Ambrose.
Okay, so hot take. I've lost all my fire for AJ ever since his pop at Royal Rumble. I don't really see the reason for him to get as much love as he's getting besides his stardom and his respect for what he's done in the past. He's not doing... He's okay, he has title runs and matches that are golden, but what else does he bring to the table? We know what he's going to give us, and that's that.
I mean, well, he gave Roman Reigns his best ever match, and Roger, he had to carry it all the way through, this. Of course.
We're not doing this.
Yes, we are.
Roger, we're not doing this.
So that you, you wait. He did, or did Daniel Bryan give him that?
No, I will maintain that AJ Styles probably gave him his best match.
You don't think Daniel Bryan gave him his best match?
Second best match.
Y'all are not going to sit in front of me talking like I'm not here knowing full well what y'all are saying.
I'm sorry. So, I mean, I don't know. Roman Reigns, it's just...
It's like Roman Reigns is barely serviceable as I think. I thought that Undertaker match proved that at WrestleMania 3.
Yeah, I thought so too.
Bloody Tombstone.
I'm sorry. It's in here, Tina. It's in here.
Like me in a sex party, I will just wait my turn till you two are finished.
I was like, but like... To answer the comments that was made by AJ Styles, what?
AJ is
this man?
He's losing
doing
steam.
God's work ever since he arrived in the company.
I'm sorry, God's work.
God's work.
You are you sliding for AJ? Because I feel you sliding for AJ.
I don't slide for anybody. But I'll be honest with you. As an atheist, I dig what that Christian man is doing to is
oh
bringing to the table.
God. He's I'm losing steam.
He's losing steam.
AJ Styles is losing just a bit of steam.
Losing steam from his excellence in wrestling or from the pop that he's getting?
I don't think so. Not even.
You're
close.
Talking completely his past work. He what has he done? You know what he's going to give you. You know what he's going to give you.
You know he's going to get a great wrestling match. You know he's going to give you a great wrestling match no matter who. Again, Shane? Come on. That was a great match.
His last match alone was great.
I was like, so you get mad for at people for being excellent? I'm very terribly confused at your statements here.
AJ does solid work. I will give you that. However, how about spreading the wealth around?
You know what?
He's had that belt forever and a day. How about giving it to someone else? And I think
Roman Reigns has had that belt forever and a day. Why don't we talk about...
Roman Reigns doesn't have a belt. Don't know if you noticed.
But do you know what? You got to remember something. Keeping the belt on AJ makes sense right now because they just announced him being the cover person for 2K19.
Yep. Well, stock price going up.
Oh, God.
Will you stop it with the stock price?
Okay, I won't stop until we reach $100 per share. That's when I'll stop.
So you're paying for us today, right?
When
drinks are on
so
you.
You're treating us today, right?
I was like, no, I'm paying for myself, and I'm paying for like 3 Jack and Cokes.
So here's my thing, right? Quick question. Rapid fire. Give it to me quick. Shout out to my boyfriend. Rusev, heel or face? Chrissy? Great.
Both.
Roger, heel or face? Give it to me quick.
Face.
Okay. I think he would work great. Oh, sorry. Ruby, I miss you. Because I usually only see you in my dreams. I forget you're sitting next to me, darling. Rusev, heel or face? Give it to me.
I appreciate him more as a heel, but face.
Lucy, heel or face? Give it to me quick.
Face.
Sunny, heel or face?
Machka.
Oh, see, you ruined it. Mandy Rose. Mandy Rose. Yeah, speaking of Rusev, Mandy Rose.
Mandy Rose, Mandy Rose. Mandy Rose.
The future.
My dick gets smaller and smaller every time that name is said. Okay, here's what I'm imagining, right? Here's what we do. AJ versus Rusev at whatever the fuck next pay-per-view is. I forget the names because Vince keeps changing them. Great Balls of Fire. Yeah, that was my favorite one.
Extreme Rules.
Is that the next one? Are you sure?
Yes.
Vince likes to change them.
No, it's Extreme Rules, which we will be doing a viewing party at Legends.
We hardly ever do viewing parties. I'm shocked. I can't remember the last viewing party.
If you want to come to one of our viewing parties, make sure that you go to yepilw.eventbrite.com. Our invite is already up for the next pay-per-view viewing party, so make sure you do that. And
if you're done with that shameless plug.
Hey, I got to do a shameless plug. And another shameless plug, get our shirts on prowrestlingtees.com/YEPILW.
Give me a size extra medium.
I was like, and I also have another shout out. Everybody should be buying WWE stock if you want to make some money, because I've made a 90% return.
That's not a thing. That's why I snatched the mic away from you.
Can I please get through my fantasy?
But it should be a thing. Please. You guys should make money for yourselves. You guys should have 401ks.
AJ Styles and Rusev at Extreme Rules. Rusev, as a face, goes over on AJ.
No.
He becomes the new champion.
No.
The entire arena loses their shit. Lana and Aiden English come running to the ring to congratulate him. They're doing the whole machka, arms up, they're doing everything. And then Rusev super kicks Lana to become a heel. Tell me that would not be the greatest swerve ever. Book it, Raja. Book it.
That would be serviceable. That would be serviceable.
I'll allow it.
Thank you. Thank you. At least I have one person on my side. Tell me you would not be blown away if Rusev turned on Lana. Come on now.
But he's done that before.
Rusev has kicked Lana?
No.
He's turned on.
Actually, Lana turned on Rusev and got with Dolph.
When she was going down on Dolph Ziggler.
Okay. Yeah,
which is a little different, but you know.
Just imagine all three of them arms raised, maybe. And then he super kicks her, and then he puts her in the accolade.
You do realize that's not going to happen.
I know.
No.
It's called
maybe on Aiden, but not her.
Fine.
You know what, I tell you, that's called my stock price literally plunging by $50.
Roger.
Actually, now I'm rooting for it.
I was like, you guys have stocks? No? I'm hearing no. I'm hearing echoes of no across this bar. No,
as much as you talk about your WWE stock, nah, I want it to drop.
I do not have
any
stock.
I was like, well, you know what, I appreciate it.
It's like when you have that one friend that just keeps on talking about their kid over and over and over and over again.
His children are beautiful.
Oh, look at my baby.
What's wrong with you?
My baby sat up and spit. Isn't it cute? Look at my baby. Oh, my baby rolled over. Your baby's 1 year old. He should be rolling over.
Other people's babies ain't making me money, so why are we talking about other people's babies?
Unless you're treating us, bro, we don't want to know.
I was like, well, I'm not treating you, but I'll tell you about the stock price. Matter of fact, I'm going to hit you up on Messenger if any more updates.
I got a rhyme, too. I don't have any stock, but I got plenty of cock. So wrap this up, Sonny, and take us home already.
And that's a wrap for episode 26. I want to thank everybody that's been here today to celebrate the general manager. I'm not saying self-proclaimed. I'm not even putting air quotations.
So sweet. Thank you guys so much. This has been the best birthday ever until I get home. Shout out to... No, we can't make that joke, Sonny, because that's filthy. Filthy, I tell you. But thank you all
so
much.
Like everything else isn't?
I am nothing if not clean on this podcast. It has been so much fun having this podcast. You all are literally, you know, lifesavers. You all don't know where I was just 6 months ago. So it's been so much fun playing with you on this podcast. I hope we can continue to do this. Thank you all for joining me for my birthday. Thank you for my card. Thank you for my gift certificate. This was really fun. Thank you all. Thank you all. Thank you all.
And since you're done with your thank yous, on behalf of myself, my name is Sonny Sofrito, and I am joined by...
Roger Adams, name dropper.
Lucy T, WWE.
The Sensational Miss Chrissy Love.
Ruby Sinatra Mendoza, and please talk to me, but only if you're talking dirty.
Oh, Ruby. I am the greatest general manager in Yep, I Like Wrestling history.
And that's a wrap. Thanks for joining us. Make sure you subscribe. Check us out. We're available on all podcast platforms, iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, and TuneIn Radio. And check out our YouTube channel, youtube.com/YEPILW, and our SoundCloud channel, soundcloud.com/YEPILW. Take care. See you next time. Peace.